Hello everybody, welcome to the Java course. In Java, we have two special types of operators that would help us to increment or decrement a variable. The first one to introduce is called the postfix operator, and the second one that would follow the discussion would be the prefix operator. So let me discuss postfix operator first. What does mean by that? We can see the effects of a postfix operator with an example. Suppose we have a variable called a, which is an integer, and the value of the variable a is 1, and then I declare another variable called b, which is also an integer primitive. When I say something like this, b equals a plus plus, what does it mean by this operation? We have to notice first that it is known as a postfix operator because we add two plus signs after the variable name. Okay. When we have this postfix operator, it means two steps. It means we assign the value of b to be having the value of a, and then I would add the value of a by 1, and then I will store the new value of a into the original variable component. Okay. So we can see the effect by printing out both a and b. Okay, let us see the result. When a is originally 1, after this line, I mean after using the postfix operator, I will have b equals 1 because we do the assignment first. So the value of a would be stored in variable b, and then I will add 1 to the original amount stored in the variable a. So a would become 2 and b would become 1 according to the order specified by the postfix operator having two plus signs. Can we have minus signs followed by the variable name? Yes, we can. We will have another effect like this. Let us see some examples. I'm now going to have d equals c minus minus. What does it mean by the postfix operator consisting of two minus signs? It has this kind of effect. It is similar to what we did for addition. First, I will put the value of c into the variable d, and after the assignment statement, I will decrease the value of c by 1, and then I will put the new value to the variable c. So we can see the effect that printed out the values of c and d. Save it and run it. Okay, c was originally 6. So d would be storing 6 after the assignment statement. And after the assignment statement, the value of c is changed to 5. So I will get c equals 5 and d equals 6. Okay, after introducing postfix operators, I'm going to introduce the prefix operator, which is a bit harder to understand. Okay, what does it mean by a prefix operator? It is quite similar to what we did for the postfix operator, except that the plus signs or minus signs are put before the variable name. Okay, we have two variables. The first variable is e, which is equal to 3. And the second variable f is equal to plus plus e. What does it mean by the plus plus e, which is known as the prefix operator? Okay, when we have the prefix operator like this, we do the addition of e by 1 first. And after doing the addition, I will assign the new value of e to the variable f. So we can see the effects by printing out both e and f. Save it, run it. Okay, both e and f would become 4. Why is this the case? I do the addition of 1 to the original value of e, which would make e become 4. And after this addition, I will assign the new value of e to the variable f. So both e and f would become 4. In addition to using two plus signs as the prefix operator, I can also use two minus signs as the prefix operator. Let us see some examples. Okay, now we have x equals minus minus g. What does it mean by this prefix operator consisting of two minus signs before the variable name? We have two steps like this. We first do the subtraction of g by 1, and I will save the new value of g to the original variable g. And after the subtraction, I will assign the new value of g to the variable h. So we can see the effects by printing out both g and h. Save it and run it. Okay, both g and h would become 7 because originally g was 8. After doing the subtraction, g becomes 7, and then I will also assign the value of 7 to the variable h. So both g and h would become 7 finally. So after this introduction, I hope you are able to understand the prefix and postfix of operators. And when you see the prefix or postfix operators, you are able to decompose the operation into two parts, like I did for the previous examples. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.